And welcome back to Fred Jackson Show. Our special guest tonight, a great Buffalo Bill in his own right and a member of the Bills Broadcast Network, Mark Kelsall, is on the show tonight. And during the commercial break, Fred was trying to clarify. He certainly didn't mean to imply that.
We understand. What he did say is that he doesn't want to be listening to the radio, but he would prefer everybody in Western New York is turn the TV on, but listen to the radio.
Yeah. Okay. Well, that's all been fixed
now.
That's
what I'm saying. Yep.
All right. So you're doing the game with John Murphy, and the game. I mean, let's face it. I mean, it's for 58 minutes. It's a horrible game for the Bills. A lot of turnovers, mistakes. But that last drive, Mark, that's just something that, you know, you got to preserve that last minute and just set it aside for all times because it was a classic.
Yeah, and what a great day to have it. And when they're honoring Van Miller and putting him up on the Wall of Fame and all the great calls that he had. But it was guys stepped up and made plays, and these guys say it all the time. I mean, you need guys that are going to step up in critical situations. And I think the play that I was most impressed with was a Chandler catch down the middle because that was a ball that was really hard to throw. Anthony Barr, the young rookie linebacker from UCLA, is a terrific player for the Vikings, and he threaded that ball, and Chandler had just dropped the ball earlier, so you don't know where his frame of mind is, and his quarterback goes right back to him, and that's a huge play. And then guys just stepped up and made plays, and you can grow up a lot in those games, and you certainly don't want games to come down to that all the time, but they learned a lesson, certainly, and they learned that even you know, when it looks like you're going to be defeated, you can kind of snatch victory from defeat with a great two-minute drive.
Yeah, one of the things in listening to the radio that I was thinking about is how do you guys keep your composure when you're calling a game like that? To me, it would be hard to not get excited about every play that's made out there. And, you know, listening to you guys are definitely able to keep your composure in time.
When you're off one of these weeks, okay, I'm going to bring you in the booth, and you can see what kind of composure I use. You don't hear that on the air, but there's plenty of times when I'm throwing papers around and upset about a play or a call or something that happened. So, yeah, I mean, you want to communicate the excitement to the fans. I mean, that's the whole point. You want to communicate the excitement on the radio because the energy in the building was just, it was so exciting and the fans were giving the Bills a big boost with the 12th man, all that energy that happens, and you want to be able to communicate that as well. But, you know, it is hard sometimes, but to keep your composure because there's a lot of things that happen, and just like you guys react to certain things that happen on the field, and being an ex-player, you know, I understand how difficult it is, and sometimes you need to be able to communicate that as well because some people don't understand that there's other guys on the side of the ball that get paid to do this job too, and sometimes they win the battle, sometimes you win the battle.
Mark, I want to ask you a question. With the great teams of the 90s you were a part of, there were some memorable comebacks, none more so than, of course, the Oilers game. But that team, when it started to gel and come together, you had some great comebacks against the Dolphins. Jim takes in the end zone. Does that truly start to build confidence in a team collectively?
Yeah, without question, I think it does. And we were in a position where we never felt we were out of a game ever. I mean, there were a couple, I think, that got out of hand on us. A Monday night game in Kansas City comes to mind. But generally, regardless of what was happening through the course of the game, you just keep playing the game, and you don't know what's going to happen. I mean, you turn the ball over, and you just have to – you hope you can hold them to a field goal so that you have an opportunity to get those points back later in the game. But it gives your team great confidence, without question.
I want to ask you, you mentioned it. Van Miller was put on the Wall of Fame at halftime. Van is just an icon. You had a chance to witness that ceremony, very moving. I mean, what, you know, you were playing the game, so you heard Van's calls after the fact. And that's what I was asking Fred if he ever heard of any of Van's calls. What is, thinking of Van Miller, what does that bring to mind to you?
Well, you know, I was thinking, we talked a little bit on the round table about growing up. I grew up in Pittsburgh, so I think of Myron Cope, and I think about all the people, because he was a great broadcaster for the Steelers through the 70s when they were winning Super Bowls. And people around here in Western New York got to experience that with Van Miller. And I think the greatest thing a broadcaster can do is to kind of transport somebody back in time to that particular moment. And if you hear some of Van's calls, whether it was a Jamie Nails touchdown when he intercepted that that pass the one time, or whether it was the 38-yard field goal from the center of the field, Adam Lingner ready to snap it back. As soon as you hear those words, right, and you associate it with that game, you put yourself right back in that situation. So he was iconic, and he grew with the team, and you know, his love affair for Buffalo and for the Buffalo Bills was just as strong as Ralph's was, I think.
All right, speaking of iconic, this young man is iconic in the Twitterverse. Ladies and gentlemen, Brad Galber. Brad, you have some questions for our guests and for Fred?
Yeah, the first one is from David, and it's for Fred. He wants to know, did you actually see CJ go down, and what was kind of the tone in the locker room afterwards?
Yeah, I actually watched the play, and it's just one of those things where, I mean, that guy so freakishly fast that when he hit the ground, you know, he just broke his collarbone, so... it was definitely tough. You know, when he came in, my wife had come to see me, and it was a hard situation to be in because, you know, I'm in there and I'm not in the best of moods. And then he comes in and he's obviously in a lot of pain, and, you know, it's not good. It's not a good look for him, and his injury is far worse than mine is. So it's one of those things you just try and let him know that you're there for him.
Okay, Brad, what's next?
Yep, the next one is for Mark, and it's from Herb. He wants to know, what's been the biggest difference you've noticed in this Bills team from teams in recent memory?
The depth at every position that we have, I think, is the biggest one that I've noticed. You know, we got, with myself and CJ going down, we got two guys that are going to step up at running back. So I think we got depth at every position like that, and you see guys continue to make plays at different positions.
Mark?
Yeah, well, I mean, this is a team, I think, that's beginning to believe in itself. And you know, I think it's a healthy situation that Kyle Wharton's playing, and EJ has an opportunity now to learn behind somebody who's had some real quality starts in this league and has put together some numbers. But you start to believe in yourself. You've got a defense that can stop teams, and now you've got an offense who proves last week that you can go down and win a game at the end of the ball game when all seems lost. So you have opportunities, and you have guys that you expect to make plays offensively that stepped up and made plays. And I think, you know, that's going to certainly bode well for the upcoming weeks here.
Okay, last one, Brad.
Yep, this one's for Fred. And Mark wants to know, what goes through your head when you get hurt? Are you thinking about how long you'll be out, your teammates, et cetera?
Well, I think, you know, all of the above. The first thing you think of is, you know, how significant is the injury? What is it I can do? How soon it is I can come back to help my teammates? You know, is this, you know, going to affect my career when I get back out here? You start thinking about all of it. But the number one thing you can do is, you know, listen to what the doctors tell you. Do everything that you can when it comes to rehabbing, and see how get back out there as soon as you can to play for your teammates.
Okay, we're going to take a break. We'll come back with DJ Dave Jixter from 97 Rock in our studio audience right after this.